When I met the Scorpions, I barely played electric guitar. I was mainly doing classical guitar and flamenco. And so Sails Of Charon really has a flamenco touch. It's not an official flamenco groove, but it's very similar, and it's got this Mideastern touch, which back then not many bands did. A little bit Led Zeppelin touched on that, maybe Rainbow a little, you know. And but it also has a major vibe as opposed to a minor vibe. And it was unusual that the guitar solo started the song kind of after the riff, but somehow it worked, and it became very influential towards the metal and guitar shredders afterwards, you know. The lyrics were inspired by a Michelangelo painting in the Sistine Chapel, where you have the Charon or Charon, it's a Greek name, is the ferryman who delivers the souls of the dead from when they arrive in the underworld. They cross the river Styx. And somehow that painting got to me, and that was the idea for that thing. Now, it's all about a person who starts getting involved with black magic and all those things that I don't believe in. And someone who basically, yeah, goes the wrong part away. Some kind of Darth Vader figure, actually.
Dark Knight. There is no light in the realm of the black magic man. Souls flight into the cold blight of the destroyer's magic land.
Incidentally, that was the year when Star Wars came out. And when I saw Star Wars for the first time, I thought, that's the one. Darth Vader. So it is... That's the story of the song, you know. We never discussed it back then like that, you know, but that was in it for me.
But that must be one of the reasons why this song really stands out from all the songs Uli wrote, and so many great artists like Billy Corgan, Kirk Hammett, and Metallica.
Yeah, he plays it every day.
You know, they
in every Metallica show, they start in his solo. He plays that.
Yeah.
That
riff. So they're also very much inspired by. We say many times by the Scorpions, but they are very much inspired, especially about Uli's work and his songs. And
that was different from Electric Sun. I could have carried on, and had I stayed with the Scorpions, that's the direction I would have carried on with, you know. But then I chose a different direction, and later on I rediscovered that, and you know, and wrote more like that, and I tend to play that song.
I mean, that
live
opening riff is so different, and so
I had the idea from listening to the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto, because there you have a slide on the open string, and that's the start of the melody. And I thought, oh, maybe I should write a violin concerto. So that's how that started, and then it became this.
I just listened to it on Uli's brand new revisited Scorpions album.
Wow.
And it's pretty cool, you know, and it shows that Uli haven't lost a bit of what he's doing and what he can do with his guitar. It's breathtaking.
sky.